Hello everybody. Today I have a look at two modern reinterpretations of classic knife designs. I'm talking about the Spyderco Chokwe and the Citadel Kukri. I will have a look first at the Chokwe. Chokwe seems like a strange name. It's actually an African city. I think it's in Angola, but I'm not fully certain. Where the local people have since a long time a very classic simple knife design. And actually, when Sal Glesser, who is the owner of Spyderco and also a knife designer, he was informed about this. He was curious enough to make his own interpretation of the classic Chokwe design. Well, actually, you may know that Spyderco actually released already a number of reinterpretations of classic designs. They also have a folding kukri, they have a barong. Probably in the future there is something that will look a bit like a Corsican knife. That's what I read somewhere in an interview. They have the Spyderco Chris, which is also inspired by a classic design from Indonesia, if I'm correct. Well, so they have done this before, and actually with this particular one, which looks at first sight quite strange, I think they may have one of their masterpieces. It's very early impressions, but I like it already very much. So I will first open it. So what I think is striking is that this is a very simple and clean design. It's so modern. While actually, when you find pictures of the original Chokwe knives, they look exactly the same, but they are a lot bigger. They are really big fixed utility knives, used for everything from in the kitchen to various chopping works. You see indeed a very, very clean, modern design. You would at first think that the handle isn't comfortable because of the geometric forms, but actually it is remarkably comfortable in the hand. So to be really precise, this isn't even straight here. There's a slight curve in here. what else here? Well, blade is CPM S30V, so it's one of the best steels you can find on the market. Absolutely nothing to improve upon. It's actually made this knife not in Spyderco Colorado, America, but in Taiwan, such as their Sage 1 and Sage 2, for example. And those who have these knives know that the quality is actually beyond reproach. It's really perfectly fit together. The handle here has two big holes that are not big enough to stick your fingers in, which is handy. You never know that could be an accident, for example. It has texture G10, but which is in my opinion luckily not as grippy that it will really stick to your pants. So it's textured, so you have a good grip, but it's quite doable. When I look now at the other side, now this is clearly a very modern interpretation, you can say, because indeed the other side features a titanium frame lock, so it looks really as a bank vault. It's absolutely without any play. You can put the clip also at the top here for tip down carry. I didn't do that yet. What else? Well, if you look here at the top, you see the blade is actually pretty thin. It's a very, very good slicer. So which also means you should be careful with it. Well, you should never pry with folding knives, but definitely not with this one. You will break the tip. But then again, a folding knife is not designed for such misuse. If you use it properly, considering the general build quality and the quality steel, it should give years of good service. And like I say, for slicing, I think, for example, for cutting food when you're on a picnic or so, this should be extremely good. What else? Ah yes, so at the right side here, next to the G10 handle material, there's a steel liner. So that's about it. So I would like to repeat how much I like the simple, clean design that on picture actually seems maybe a bit abstract almost, like modern art. Well, in the hand, yes, it's like modern art, I would still say. It looks timeless. While it's a classic design, And actually, it's something that works very well. So you could perhaps argue for in modernizing that it could have used here a bit of jimping to hold the finger better when you do a precision cutting. But I don't think it matters that much. I think that jimping is overrated. Actually, there is by the way a bit here, which is good that your finger won't slip up onto the blade. In general, I prefer here the very, very clean look of it. So I think really, really a light, very well made masterpiece. Modern, and already I think this one will be remembered as one of the great Spider-Cores. So have a look now at the other one. So it's another interpretation of a classic knife. Citadel is an interesting company led by a French manager, and they are actually based in Cambodia. All their knives are totally handmade. So here we have a folding kukri. Kukri is actually typically a fixed blade originating from Nepal that can be used for tough chopping work and as a big weapon. Interesting blades when you see their form. And actually, the Spider-Core that we just saw, the company also has a folding interpretation of it, which is in typical Spider-Core fashion very, very high-tech modern. Here, in contrast, I would say the Citadel is decidedly classic. It uses here a palisander wood handle. It also exists in buffalo horn tip. You can see already at the spine there is a lovely, lovely filework. It's nicely decorated. It's quite heavy and sturdy, the knife. It's not, I must say, it's a bit bigger for EDC, but then you get a sheet with it, a belt sheet, which helps the carrying. Notice also there is some filework here at the top of the blade. So it is already a very classical approach to a reinterpretation than what the Spider-Core does. And actually, I think that both have their merits. Strictly two-hand, eh? You saw how I opened it. You cannot open it with one hand. Blade is carbon steel with actually differential heat treatment with the spine, the thick spine, by the way. It's 3 millimeter roughly. I mean, this is a solid knife, really, really solid. While you should actually not use a folder for heavy chopping, well, this folder is definitely sturdier than most. Well, anyway, the top here is relatively soft, while the blade material is suitably very hard. So this gives a good combination of strength and hardness for the cutting. And the typical kukri form is with the blade that slopes downwards, which actually is handy when you cut something above a table. You don't have to tilt your hand. You can cut easily like that. So it is actually a blade material that works pretty well. What else? Well, this Citadel is a liner lock. It's a thick liner. Certainly 1 millimeter. It locks really well. There's absolutely no play in this design. So, well, yes, you Cambodia, I mean, which actually guarantees, you could say, the craftsmanship. It's really handmade. And also, well, let's face it, the cost of labor is less high there. That also causes that this knife is actually offered at a really interesting price, considering that you get something with truly a lot of character. I really think that the Citadel Kukri is nice, but like I said, it's heavy and it's big, it's a handful. I mean, you will be frowned upon by people who are not knife nuts, that's for sure. But it's a fun thing for general utility, and especially it looks wonderful. I will put them again briefly side by side for you to judge, and feel free to leave that as a feedback in YouTube. Which one do you like most? Well, this is really not an easy choice. Well, definitely the Spider-Core is much easier for everyday carry. You have a classic look still of the Kukri, but with a lot of nice features like a good liner lock, beautiful classic firework made in Cambodia from Citadel, and again the modern looking, but anyway, the original knife was already modern looking Shockwave from Spider-Core. I think a new masterpiece. Well, that was it. As usual, feel free to leave bluntly honest feedback.